let me tell you a little bit about what is Web 3.0. The first interaction of the web represents the Web 1.0, which is the read-only web. In other words, the early web allowed us to search for information and read it. There was very little in the way of user interaction or content generation. This was what most website owners wanted. They needed a website to make their information available to anyone at any time. This is the brick and mortar thinking applied to the web. Then it came 2.0. The term Web 2.0 first came into use in 1999 as the internet pivoted towards a system that actively engages the user. Users were encouraged to provide content rather than just viewing it. People were now able to publish articles and comments, and it became possible to create user accounts on different sites, therefore increasing participation. Web 2.0 also gave rise to web apps, such as self-publishing platforms like WordPress, as well as social media sites. Now, Web 3.0 is the third generation of internet services for websites and applications that will focus on using a machine-based understanding of data to provide a data-driven and semantic web. The ultimate goal of Web3 is to create more intelligent, connected, and open websites. Therefore, users and machines will be able to interact with data. But for this to happen, programs need to understand information both conceptually and contextually. With this in mind, the two cornerstones of Web3 are semantic web and artificial intelligence, or AI. What is the metaverse? In the broadest terms, the metaverse is understood as a graphically rich virtual space with some degree of realism, where people can work, play, shop, socialize, and sure, do the things humans like to do together in real life, or perhaps more to the point, on the internet. Metaverse proponents often focus on concept of presence as a defined factor. Feeling like you're really there and feeling like other people are really there with you too. But there is a thing. It actually doesn't exist. But the current platforms are centralized and exist as walled gardens. Until someone can visually walk out from one game into another, it will be challenging to say that the metaverse has truly arrived. We are far from the idea that these metaverse-like experiences will be interpolable, as not all of these experiences are built upon the same technology or have the intention of becoming compatible with the other projects. Game platforms demonstrate the global appetite for the virtual worlds, but it will only truly become the real metaverse when we can walk into our screens and move between platforms. Now, introducing Gmeta.One. Gmeta.One is a hybrid metaverse ecosystem with an interconnecting metaverse, business development, networking, real estate, and education objectives. The Gmeta.One project is also an effective bridge, bridging our world with other hybrid metaverses representing an expanding network of three-dimensional Web3 worlds, with equally expanding value in the form of increasing accessibility to additional metaverse communities in our future network. About Gmeta.One, a significant part of Gmeta.One's mission and platform is founded upon education, with another pillar rooted into networking and business development, founded upon a metaverse environment designed with the technological capacity to allow individuals to build, buy, sell, and rent metaverse real estate. We are bridging together education and development while creating a fulfilling metaverse experience environment for developers, metaverse real estate brokers, owners, NFT creators, virtual event hosts and planners, e-commerce merchants and B2B offerings, and newcomers to the metaverse. Well, to be honest, it's like for everyone, right? Oops. Why Gmeta.One is different? And why is Gmeta.One is different? Why do you think Gmeta.One is different from the ones that heard this presentation a few times? Tell me, why is Gmeta.One different from other metaverse-related projects? Why are we different? Gmeta.One seeks to be a bridge between the Gmeta.One world and other metaverses. We have unique offerings with our Gmeta NFT proposition and other communities in our ecosystem, like Gmeta.One V Academy, educational portal, and business and advertising marketplaces. But the bridges we create between metaverses, as well as contractors to clients, truly distinguish us from any other cryptocurrency project. In addition, token will be launched on Binance Smart Chain, which is faster, more flexible, and cheaper for our users. We will offer a bridging solution to use Ethereum and Polygon. Our pre-sale bonus offers 100% and 50% for sharing and bringing others to the platform just on the pre-sale. In pre-sale, we also offer NFT giveaways, incentives, VR headsets, and even luxury vehicle prizes. The bridging, definite bridging. We build bridge. All right. We are different because we are the bridge in the metaverse. Okay. So we are the ones doing that connection between digital universes. We are architects of the metaverse, not architects of the metaverse. No. We are architects of metaverse, okay? Because saying architects of the metaverse, it means that we're the only ones. We're not the only ones, okay? But we are architects of metaverse. There we go. Thank you, Definite. Building bridges. Gmeta.One has already established premises in other metaverse projects, and we will continue to do so as part of our ongoing mission to becoming a bridge connecting multiple digital universes. Some of our locations include Voxels, the Gmeta.One arena, which has hosted live stream events such as Miami NFT Week, South by Southwest 2002, an exclusive event with Wiz Khalifa. We also have apartments for rental in Gmeta Heights and several other premises. And a very, very cool event coming on the 6th. A very cool event coming on the 6th of July. Our global gathering, which is going to be absolutely awesome. We also have this in Decentraland. We have a 4-story HQ established in a permanent site area. Now, guys, permanent site area is important, just like anywhere, just like in real life, right? You don't want to have your site in the middle of the jungle where no one goes or no one passes, right? You want to have in a prominent area where there's people passing around. And that's where we always focus. We focus on prominent places. In Somnium Space, we have another arena venue. And we also have an entire world for future use. In the beginning, let me tell you a little of the story of Metaverse. It's important to understand this. Second Life was launched in June 2003. It was a pioneer for what we now know as the Metaverse. Users can purchase avatars, wearables, property, vehicles, etc. using its own internal currency, Linden dollars, which are only available to purchase for users on the platform. Linden dollars are not externally tradable and not a cryptocurrency. By 2013, despite having over 64 million registered users, Second Life had just over a million active registered users. And this hasn't really increased appreciably since. Second Life, Life remains the trailblazer for all current metaverse projects. Now, let me tell you about three established metaverse projects: Sandbox, Decentraland, and Somnium Space. Sandbox started with an average land price of $100 and now has an average land price of $15,000. Got a token called Sand, with over 150,000 holders, where the pre-launch was done at 8 cents. It went to a all-time low of 3 cents and an all-time high of $8.40. Then also in 2020, 1 year earlier, That was another project, Decentraland, which started with land price at $20 per parcel. $20. And is now have, now land prices on average over around $12,000 in 2022. Token is called Mana, and holders, and it's got over 212,000 holders. Price at launch was 2 cents, with an all-time high of 1 cent, all-time low of 1 cent, and all-time high of $5.85. Guys, pay close attention to these numbers, because this is reflection of what we can achieve with our own project, okay? This could be a reflection, because no one can tell, oh, it's going to do this, going to do that. We don't know, right? But we can compare with what already been happening. But before those two, before Sandbox and Decentraland, there was another one that was called Somnian Space. Somnian Space, with an average land price of $500 at launch, and which now achieved an average land price of $10,000, has got a token called Cube with over 4,000 users as holders, and price at launch was 2 cents, all-time low of 3 cents, all-time high of $28.12. Now, important, compared to what we're doing, they don't have not even close the amount of utility we are adding to this token, to our, what we are doing. But let me tell you more. GMO token. GMO is the power of Gmeta.One ecosystem. Everything from paying for educational courses in Gmeta.One V Academy platform to buying land in the Gmeta.One virtual world and all things Gmeta. All things Gmeta. Therefore, the use cases are undeniable. We are raising $5 million USD via GMO token presale. Currently, over 5,000 holders and over 15,000 signed up. 20% of the total supply of 1 trillion will go into presale. Of this amount, 2.5 million will go into locked liquidity. The price at launch, when it goes on sale to the general public, will be of 0.000025. So still extremely affordable, even at launch. But for example, if you bought $20 today at $1,000, you will receive 43 million GMO tokens at the launch. These will be worth $1,075. Now, can we guarantee this price? Of course not. We're not financial advisors or anything alike. Okay. But we know by maths that it will be at that price at launch. Will it stay there? We don't know. Will it go down? We don't know. Will it go up? There's a big probability, right? So it's 1%. GMO token has a tax of 2.5%. 1% will be purchase and burn. 1% will be for development and marketing, and 1% will be for the holders with over 1 billion tokens staking. So 0.5% will be a share for those holders. The total GMO supply is 1 trillion, where 40% of the total GMO supply will be to burn, 20% will be for the global presale, 30% will be for the marketing and development, and 10% will be for liquidity. In the press, Gmeta.One has featured strongly in crypto, tech, investment, and other online publications. You just search, go on Google, search by yourself, and type Gmeta.One, Gmeta.One, and you will see the amount of publications in all different languages. You got publications in Coinpedia, in Bitcoinist, in Cointelegraph, in AMB Crypto, Last Minute Crypto, investing.com, and a lot more. So if you think, oh, this is cool, is there anything that I can show to others? There you go. You got hundreds, if not thousands, of publications that you can show. You can see and you can show. I go too much now. Now, who is involved in the metaverse? who is involved in the metaverse, from celebrities like Snoop Dogg, Paris Hilton, Lady Gaga, Madonna, Shawn Mendes, Grant Cardone, Method Man from Wu-Tang Clan, LeBron James, Rihanna, Floyd Mayweather, Shaquille O'Neal, Jay-Z, Travis Scott, and Wiz Khalifa, as we know, because we did an event on our on our parcel, right? And Jeanette is also a celebrity that is involved in the metaverse. So fashion brands, you got Gucci, Louis Vuitton, Burberry, Givenchy, Zara, Tommy Hilfiger, and many more, as you can see on the screen. Food and drinks, McDonald's, Coca-Cola, Wendy's, there's so many. Sports brand, Nike, Adidas, Puma, Reebok, Asics, financial, JP Morgan, which I was on their parcel the other day. JP Morgan is definitely involved in the metaverse. Citibank is definitely involved in the metaverse, especially with the statement they put out. HSBC, American Express, Morgan Stanley, MasterCard, who just filed 15 patents related to NFT and the metaverse. This is MasterCard, guys, MasterCard. So we know where they're going, right? There's also a travel and tourism. There's a lot. Celebrity cruises, Emirates Airways, Singapore Airlines, Lufthansa. There's so many. Technology, Sony, Samsung, Nintendo, Microsoft, retail, Selfridges, Walmart, which I even showed a few of the things they're developing in the metaverse here on our calls. And I'll be showing it again this week. So, but why are they getting involved? The metaverse economy could be an $8 trillion to $13 trillion total addressable market by 2030. And this is by Citibank, not by us. It's not Gmeta.One saying this. This was Citibank. And if you grab this statement, the metaverse economy could be an $8 trillion to $13 trillion. You can actually read the whole story from Citibank online. Copy this statement, search it. It is extremely, extremely interesting. The benefit of having a metaverse presence for any business are innumerous. Permits business to reach a global audience without geographical limitations. Allow business to interact with their customers in a more personal way. A more sociable and engaging experience for customers which can lead to more sales and long-term loyalty. Your virtual premises in our metaverse and everything in it will be NFTs. You can stake to earn passive income. Businesses can also use virtual worlds to train their employees, replicating real-world experiences to let their team practice in advance. Businesses can test out on new products and services without having to invest in physical infrastructure or risk negative publicity. The advantages are so many. The benefits are, it's actually here on this page is only a tiny little fraction of all the benefits that you can get. And you can see there's in numerous publications talking about how the metaverse will improve real life. Opportunity to buy, sell, rent, stake metaverse parcels. Anything you can do in the real world, you can do in the metaverse. And in fact, more. As a landowner, you can choose to lend out the experience of working on the land with other people in the digital world. Mall shops and even centers allow creators to showcase their content collection, giving a brand new commercial letting opportunity. Metaverse projects with staking pools allow you to purchase land and stake it as NFT, giving the owners a passive income stream. Once a metaverse project achieves a certain level of popularity, as in the real world, this creates desirable areas and prices react dramatically. When I say dramatically, it's completely different from real world in that sense, because they react a lot faster than in the real world. Our metaverse services, Gmeta.One has a huge portfolio of services we can offer our members, both in the metaverse and those with which we have a bridge. Gmeta.One verse NFT land. NFT utility buildings for Gmeta.One verse, NFT road names for Gmeta.One verse, venue rentals in the Gmeta.One verse, NFT monuments for Gmeta.One verse, venue rentals in other digital world parcels, NFT wearables, building contracting services, billboard purchase in the Gmeta.One verse, billboard rentals in Gmeta.One verse, billboard rentals in other digital universes, digital universe activations, digital universe metaverse education, virtual companies formation, VLC and VLTD, and university level digital education, advertising service, and a lot more. Our team moves as a unit, much like the structure of our token community, driven by the unified whole. We move as a unified organism, the Gmeta.One professional core team, having no identified leader, but instead all inherently owning our roles, thereby keeping our professional environment positive and competitive. And you can see much more about the team on our website. I'm going to show you in a few moments. Imagine a market free from the traditional barriers to entry, a platform where you can promote your brand globally, a currency with huge liquidity and infinite usage, a world where anyone can participate and stake their claim. Welcome to Gmeta.One. And this is our presentation, guys. Thank you very much. Now let me show. Oops, what did I do? Okay, that was the wrong. That was the wrong place. All right. So let me share my screen back onto my browser. There we go. All right, you guys still there? Put a one in the chat if you're still there. Making sure anyone fell asleep. Put a one in the chat. I want to see those ones. I want to see those ones. All right. Okay, we can see one. Oh, Coco actually wrote one. All right, I can see Andy is wide awake because he put a load of ones. Oh, nice one, Stash. Nice one. All right. Good stuff. Okay. Okay. So you guys can see my screen. This is our website. For the ones that don't know about, I think most of you know, but just in case someone is or doesn't know or wants to know a little bit more, or wants to listen to it again or wants to learn about it. There's a lot of things that you can do on our website. There's a lot of information. Let me put up this a little bit bigger. All right. There's a lot of information, especially here on those tabs. Now, these tabs, there's one which is about to change. There's one that is very close from being added, which is a tab saying shop. It's a tab saying shop because we'll be adding a lot of our utility available for people to purchase with our pre-sale token, okay? With our pre-sale token. With what is our pre-sale token called? Can anyone tell me there in the chat? What is the name of our pre-sale token? Or just the ticker. You don't need the whole name, just the ticker. Put there in the chat, the tick GMOPA. Wow, hey, Ham. A fireman, Recon, you're fast, man. And Mike, that was close. Mike, that was close. Definite, Des. Oh, Jeanette was like, yeah, that's a professional. See, she put the pounds, the dollar sign before GMOPA. You see, that's. Guys, if you're listening to this for the first time, we like to have a little bit of fun, okay? We hate those presentations, which is like so boring that we fall asleep like all the time. And then we like a little bit of fun. We like a few comments. We like to pick on Samuel, for example. And stuff like that. I bet he's laughing already. All right, guys. So this is our website. this menu, and I'm looking, where is my mouse? Okay, I'm gonna have to do it like that. My mouse stopped working. Okay, so this menu right on top is the most important menu because it's got a lot of information about everything that we do. But if you scroll down, you can even see some of the parcels that we own, some of the things that we are doing, some of the plans, so the tokenomics. There's a lot of information here, especially on this one here, where the tab actually called the information, which you can see about Gmeta, so about the team, and you can see the white paper, you can see the roadmap, and you can there's a lot of things here. Okay, just for example, the white paper and roadmap, they're massive. They're really, really nice. They're not complete, mind. They're actually not complete. They've got a lot more information in detail, but is not complete. There's a lot of things that we need to add to the white paper and to the roadmap, which we'd be sharing with all the community on our calls. That's why it's important to be on the calls. So many people come to us and say, oh, so when you're sending the tokens to our wallet, and it's like, you already got the tokens in your wallet. Oh, really? Yeah, for the past few months, it's already on your wallet for the past few months. People don't know that they already got the pre-sale token in their wallets. How many? They don't know. We received numerous emails of people saying, oh, you still didn't send me my tokens. They already been in their wallets for months. All right, guys. So once you want, you decide, Gmeta.One, this is awesome. I want to join. This is really cool. This is brilliant. Someone gave me a referral link, and you press that referral link. Then you have a registration form. And that registration form, there's one special part there where you have to put your BSC wallet from a MetaMask or Trust wallet. Now, it's important. It has to be from a MetaMask or Trust wallet or from one which will enable you to change between chains, okay? Do not put a BSC wallet, Binance Smart Chain wallet, from Binance Exchange or any other exchange, because you cannot change between networks, okay? It's important for you to realize that. If you're using an exchange wallet, the whatever you got in that exchange wallet is not actually yours, because if the exchange closes, that's it. You will never have access to it, okay? So use a wallet, your wallet, where you got your keys. Where you have your keys. If you don't have your keys, it's not your tokens. Have you ever heard of that? If you never heard of that, it's the most important phrase in cryptocurrency. All right. So remember, Trust Wallet or MetaMask, those two. Why we use those two? Because then we will be able to use the other networks that we will be bridging onto. So one, we are in BSC, Binance Smart Chain. Two, we will be bridging into Ethereum. And three, we will be bridging into Polygon or Matic. So Matic, we are already using it as NFT. So for example, if someone wins something while we're doing a giveaway, we ask for their username, we send the NFT to their registered wallet in their back office. Now, if their wallet is on an exchange, how are you going to use that wallet on OpenSea? If you won't be able to, it needs to be on a personal wallet. Okay. I always like to emphasize that because I think it's very, very important. I've seen a few people that made it wrong, put a wallet from an exchange, and now they're going to have to wait. They're going to have to wait until the token is actually launched in that exchange, which will happen. But how fast, how soon, how quick, you know, they're going to have to wait. Hey, on another hand, hey, they might forget about it when they look at it. It's like worth millions. So you never know, right? I do believe that everything happens for a reason. So you never know. All right.